Hello friends, welcome to C programming tutorials. In this class we are going to learn about loops in C. C has three loop statements. One is while for do while. In this, so while and for, these two are the pretest loops. Pretest loops. So this do while is post test loop. I hope you all are know that. So pretest loop is nothing but before going to execute the statements, you are going to check the test. So post test loop is nothing but, so first you are going to execute the statements, then you are going to check the test condition. So now you see while loop. So this is the syntax for while loop. So you can write while statement. After that, in these brackets, you are going to write the condition. After the condition, if you have only one statement, then no need of these flower brackets. If you have more than one statement to execute, then you are going to use these brackets. Okay. So similarly, so this is the syntax for loop. So first statement have three parts. So one is initialization part. This is the first part. Second one, condition. And third one, updating increment or decrement. In this while loop also, you are going to write the initialization here. Initialization here. So after that, you can write condition. You can write updations in these statements. So here, the initialization, condition, and increment or decrement. So this is the statements you are going to execute. And the post test loop is, so do while loop. That means, so first you are going to do these statements. After you are going to check some condition. So this is the syntax. You can write do statements and some open bracket, some close bracket. In this, you are going to write the statements. So of this, you can write while, condition, and you can write semicolon here. Okay. So coming to while, we don't have any semicolon here. For loop also, there is no semicolon. But for do while, if you are using the do while, then at the end of this while you are going to write the semicolon. Okay, now we are going to see the example. Here you are going to write one program. That program is going to print the numbers. So for example, I entered a number 10. Then it prints 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, if I enter 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 is the output. If I enter 3, then the output is 3, 2, 1. Okay. Here you are going to read the one value from the keyboard and you can decrement the value up to the value becomes 0. Here you are going to read the value from the keyboard. So here I am taking one variable and I read the value from the keyboard, so I can write scanf. Okay. So this enter any number is displayed on the monitor. And the cursor is waiting. If I enter 10, the 10 is stored in NUM. NUM equals to 10. The next instruction is while. If the number is 10, what is the output? The output is 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. In this output, you are going to execute one instruction repeatedly. What is the instruction? Print the number. Print the number. So I put this instruction in while loop. So why? I want to execute this instruction repeatedly. So I can write this instruction in while loop. While, so what is the initial value of NUM? 10. 10 greater than 0. If this condition is true, then you are going to enter into this block. This is the condition true. So enter into this block. Printf percentage %d NUM. So what is the NUM value? 10, so it prints 10. So next, NUM minus minus. Content in the NUM is decremented by 1, so NUM becomes 9. So after this, again it goes to condition. So 9 greater than 0, true. So enter into this block and print NUM. Again, NUM minus minus, it becomes 8. Again, we check the condition. 8 greater than 0, true, you are going to print. Similarly, so when NUM becomes 1, NUM minus minus, now NUM becomes 0. So 0 greater than 0, false. We terminate the loop. At that time, the output is 10987654321. Okay, now we see the same program with the help of for loop. Here also you are going to take the variable num and you read the value from the keyboard. For example, the value is 5, and here I am taking the initialization and condition. So this is updating, either it is increment or decrement. So I am taking another variable I value, I equals to num, that means a 5. 5 greater than 0, yes it is true, so enter into this block. That means if this condition is true, you enter into this block. If the condition is false, then go to exit. You terminate the loop. Okay, so 5 greater than 0. So percentage I, what is I value? 5. The next, the control goes to updation, increment or decrement. I minus minus means I becomes 4. Again, it checks the condition. So 4 greater than 0, it is true. So enter into the block, print the I value. Again the control goes to I minus minus, so I becomes 3. So 3 greater than 0, true, print I value. Again the control goes to here, 3 minus minus means 2. So 2 greater than 0, true, so enter into this block, print 2. Again I minus minus, 1, 1 greater than 0, true, print I value 1. Again control goes to here, I minus minus, 0, so 0 greater than 0, false. So it breaks the loop. Okay, in for loop, you are going to initialize first. After that, condition. If this condition is true, you execute these statements, you enter into the block. Otherwise, you exit from the block. After execution of these statements, you are going to update the value, increment or decrement. And again, then goes to the condition. If this condition is true, again, you are going to execute these statements. Otherwise, terminate the loop. Okay, so in this way you are going to execute for loop. The same example by using do while. So what is the difference between while and do while? It is very important question in your final exam also. What is the difference between while and do while? So while is a pre-test condition. So before going to execute these statements, you are going to check the condition in while loop. But coming to do while, it is a post-test condition. So first execute the statement, then you are going to check the condition. So do, first execute, then check the condition. Okay, the same example here, enter num equals to 3. Let us assume num equals to 3. What is the expected output? The expected output is 3, 2, 1. So do printf num. What is the num value? 3. So num minus minus, now it num becomes 2. After that, you check the condition. So 2 greater than 0, yes, it is true. So again, you go to execute this instruction. So 2 num minus minus means, now num equals to 1. 1 greater than 0, true. So you are going to execute this instruction, print 1. Num minus minus, it becomes 0. So 0 greater than 0, false. So you terminate the loop. Okay, I hope you all are understand the loops in C. So while, for loop, do while loop. If the condition is, so fails in first iteration only, in while loop you don't enter into this loop. But coming to do while, if the condition fails in first iteration, then also you execute this block at least one time. Okay, that is the difference between so pre-test loop and post-test loop. So now we are going to see the execution of the program. So this is while loop. So condition, these are the statements you are going to execute. We execute this program, gcc program 18.c .slash a dot out. So enter a number between 1 to 100. I enter 20. Now it prints 20, 19, 18 up to 1. The same program with the help of for loop. GCC program 20.c. So dot slash a dot out. So I enter, the number is 20. Okay.
So here you are going to initialize condition, and this is increment or decrement updation. Okay, the same program with the help of do while. So GCC program 19.c, so .a.out. So enter any number, I enter the number is 15. Okay, it prints 15 to 1.